This
both of you
conference will
about
now be recorded.
you may observe the flow of energy in both of your palm. Just enjoy this energy. Experience this energy. Now slowly, slowly take your both the hand on your lap. Your spinal cord should be upright and straight. Your concentration on top of your head. Now observe the feeling on both of your palm and top of your head. हमें अपने दोनों हाथों के हथेलियों पे क्या महसूस हो रहा है उसे देखेंगे, उसे महसूस करेंगे, उसका आनंद लेंगे। We'll pray in our heart, Mother, please give me a complete balance. श्री माता जी, मुझे संपूर्ण संतुलन प्रदान कीजिए। Now slowly, slowly raise your left hand, put on lower part of your abdominal on right side. Raise our left hand, put lower part of abdominal on right side. Press it little bit hard. And here we'll pray. Please cool down my liver. Mother, please cool down my liver. मेरे लीवर में नैसर्गिक ठंडी आ जाए, वो ठंडा हो जाए। We may feel that there will be some energy coming from our right hand palm and our thoughts are very less now. Now slowly, slowly take your both the hand again on lap. Your eyes will be closed. Your spinal cord should be upright and straight. Now raise our right hand, put on our heart, little left side. Press it little bit hard. And here you need to pray. Mother, I am the pure spirit. Mother, I am the pure spirit. You need to say 12 times in your heart, Shri Mataji, main ek shuddha atma hu. Now slowly, slowly take right hand, put horizontally on your forehead. अपना सीधा हाथ माथे पे रखना है, जहां टीका लगाते हैं, सर दुखता है वहां पे आड़ा। थोड़ा जोर से दबाएंगे, थोड़ा सर के तरफ झुकाएंगे, नीचे जमीन की ओर झुकाएंगे, और यहाँ पे सिर्फ एक प्रार्थना करना है। मैंने सबको क्षमा की है। Do not think about any individual. Just from the bottom of heart, you need to say, I forgive everyone, including myself. सबको क्षमा करना है बस, और कुछ नहीं करना है, सबको क्षमा कर देंगे हम। एज यू फॉरगिव एवरी वन, योर थॉट प्रोसेस विल स्टॉप एंड यू विल गो इन अ डीपर एंड डीपर मेडिटेशन स्टेट एंड यूर इम्यून पावर गेट इम्प्रूव, यू गेट द डीप मेडिटेशन स्टेट। नाउ लास्ट स्टेप, पुट अवर राइट हैंड टॉप ऑफ अवर हेड, प्रेस इट लिटिल बिट हार्ड, रोटेट 7 टाइम क्लॉक वाइज डायरेक्शन एंड हियर यू नीड टू प्रे, मदर प्लीज गिव मी माई सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन, मदर प्लीज गिव माई सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन। यू नीड टू से 7 टाइम्स एंड रोटेट पाम 7 टाइम क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन एंड विद द फुल कॉन्फिडेंस इन योर हार्ट यू नीड टू प्रे, ओ मदर प्लीज गिव माई सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन, श्री माता जी मुझे मेरा आत्म साक्षात्कार प्रदान कीजिए। Now take both the hand on your lap and we'll do the meditation for few minute. Take your both the hand on your lap, be relaxed. Your spinal cord should be upright and straight and we are doing the meditation for few minute. Do not open your eyes till next instruction.
फाइंड आसान रेसिपीज गूगल की होम के साथ।
With this position, we'll observe our both of our palm and top of our head. We may feel cool or hot breeze coming from our hand and top of our head. जस्ट एंजॉय दिस फीलिंग. दिस इज अ स्टेट ऑफ मेडिटेशन वेयर वी फील द थॉटलेस अवेयरनेस, तुरिया स्टेट वेयर नो थॉट्स आर देयर, जस्ट वी आर मेडिटेटिंग. दिस इज द स्टेट वेयर वी कैन अचीव, वी कैन इवॉल्व, वी कैन अचीव लॉट ऑफ थिंग, अ पीस, इनर फ्रीडम, द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ जॉय. Now slowly, slowly you can open your eyes. Very slowly you can open your eyes. Very comfortably you can open your eyes. Just observe the screen for just 1 or 2 minutes. Do not think much because you are in a very good meditation state. Now slowly raise your right hand, put on top of your head and see if there is a cool or hot breeze coming from your head. Just observe that. Maybe if you can switch on your video for 1 or 2 minutes, that will be great. Can you just switch on your video for 1 or 2 minutes? Do this step with the right hand, your left hand on your lap and right hand on top of your head. So thank you, sir, for switching on. I will request you other participant if they can switch on their video just for 1 or 2 minutes. Now do step again by taking right hand on our lap and left hand on again on top of our head. Very slowly you need to do, very slowly. Don't do it in very hurry step, very slowly, because it is a very minute energy. I request all other participants just for few minutes if they can switch on their video only for 1 and 2 minutes. Do with the left hand on top of your head, right hand on your lap, and see if there is a cool or hot breeze. Again, try with the right hand on. Left hand on our lap and right hand on top of our head. So thank you. Now be in a relaxed position. So today is our last day. So I thank you and we will take a few questions which will be going to help you in the future meditation step. So I will encourage you to open your mic and ask if you have any questions, or I will encourage you to ask in the chat like how to do the meditation or whichever you have any question which you want to discuss, because today is the last session. We may not going to interact again in next few months, so it's better to discuss whatever the question you have. So, do you have any questions?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sir, will you share this recording? That means for doing the meditation.
Ma'am, I do not have this recording, but what I can do, I can share you some YouTube video, and there is a website called as freemeditation.com where you will get a lot of videos on doing this meditation, and offline course. Let me share that now only. So
sir, number of videos, which one is the best one, which one would be best, sir, that just share us.
I can share you the that information. Also, I will share you some online meditation, some offline meditation, so that you can do whenever you have a time, and you can do.
So thank you very much. Very nice session, sir. Thank you again, sir.
Any more question, ma'am?
No, sir.
Okay.
Thank you
very much. I am getting a mild sleep. Is it good? No, ma'am. Actually, mild sleep means you are going on a left side, because when we do a meditation and if we are getting a sleep, that means our left side, which we call as the Ida Nadi. So we are going much toward the Ida Nadi. That is why we are getting a sleep. So we should not get the sleep in meditation. That is one important topic. Whenever you do meditation, you should always be in an active, or you should be thoughtless awareness, but not in a sleep state. So you need to work hard. You need to put it on the our left hand on lever and do the meditation. So that will help you, that you will not get the sleep. So, ma'am, you asked me the question like where we can get the link. So I posted one online meditation.org link here, where you get a lot of meditation link. Okay, so then I hope I addressed the answer for getting a mild sleep. Then how much time in general it will take to come the Atma Sakshatkar? Atma Sakshatkar is the process or a step where your kundalini get activated, and that process is already happened. So you got your Atma Sakshatkar, but this kundalini is made up of thousand and thousand thread. So when you get the Atma Sakshatkar, there are one or two thread get activated, not a whole kundalini. But once you get a complete kundalini get activated, you feel lot more cool and lot many benefit. So Atma Sakshatkar you are already received. Now what you need to do is you need to practice more and experience this energy. So hope Chandrasekhar Reddy sir, I address your question. If you have any more, please feel free to ask. Manish Bharadwaj sir told, this is really nice activity in FDP. Thank you, sir. Thank you for appreciating. Then as we are using a laptop continuously during this COVID-19 lockdown, so we need some rest in eyes also as they are being stressed. Yeah, sir, this is a one good motive. This is the one purpose of doing the meditation. If you are sitting continuously in front of a laptop in 8 to 10 hour, you need a little rest, not only for your eyes, but your spinal cord, your brain, your body structure. So by just doing this meditation, what will happen? You will get the rest in your eyes as well as your spinal cord, and you will be completely relaxed. By just doing a 5-minute meditation, you boost your energy for whole day, or you get a lot of positive vibration, which we say positive energy, and you will be fit overall the day. So this is a very good, and thank you for asking this question, sir. It helped other also. My friend is always in tension and he is not believe yoga. How to help my friend? Sir, even I used to not believe in the yoga or meditation when I am in working in Wipro Technology. I thought, okay, these are all are the just one or another way of taking a money. But when I attended Sahaj Yoga first time, that night I got a very good sleep, because I'm taking a 3 antibiotic per day. And from that time onward, start believing on the yoga and continue doing the yoga, and it gave me a lot of benefit. You will not believe, from 2011, I didn't take any antibiotic. So these are some of the example you can share with your friend, or जस्ट ही वॉन्ट जस्ट आस्क हिम टू कंसिडर दिस एज अ हाइपोथेसिस एंड अटेंड एंड डू फॉर 8 days एंड लेट ऑब्जर्व वॉट चेंजेस यू विल ऑब्जर्व इन यूर ओन बीइंग एंड देन ही कैन स्टार्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द बेनिफिट ऑफ योगा. सो होप आई एड्रेस रेड्डी सर योर क्वेश्चन. देन रिचा मैम आस सर काइंडली एक्सप्लेन हाउ मेडिटेशन कैन रिड्यूस द ब्रीदिंग एंड अस्थमा प्रॉब्लम. ओके सो ब्रीदिंग दिस इज वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. थैंक यू रिचा मैम फॉर आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन. जनरली ब्रीदिंग इज वॉट ब्रीदिंग इज अ सिक्वेंस वेयर we are taking a breathing in some sequence and we are reduce, removing the breathing. This we call as a pranayam. But when you do a meditation, whatever breathing exercise is required for your body, that will happen automatically. So you don't need to do any effort. It should be a very spontaneous and it reduces the breathing and you go deep inside in your being. So that is the one good. And for asthma patient, if they do this regularly, there are a lot of cases where the asthma is 95% cure. So even there are a lot of my friend circle, there are a lot of hospital where with the help of Sahaj Yoga technique, the asthma got cure. There is no meditation, there is no medicine given to that patient once he is in active state. Right now you need to take the medicine and do the meditation regularly, but once your state get improved, you don't need to take a medicine for asthma and you get cure completely with the meditation. So you try it. Actually, if even I can give you 10 example or I can give you 10 benefit, but unless and until you don't try this by own, it will not be helpful. So you need to try that thing. So hope Richa ma'am, I address your question. And then Chandrasekhar Reddy sir, how to get rid of angry from unnecessary things? So when first question we need to understand why we get the anger. We get the anger because we get the frustration. Why we get the frustration? Because something we are expecting and that didn't happen. That is why we are getting frustration, and then frustration going to the anger, and anger then it will do some unnecessary thing. So to control the anger, you need to control the frustration. To control the frustration, you need to be in a balance, and to balance that means you should do your left or right side balancing. Because if there is an imbalance in your Ida Nadi or Pingla Nadi, then you get the frustration, you get the stress, and then it leads to anger. So best way, if you think that you are getting angry, just do a balancing of your left and right. The anger will go away. By doing this meditation, we will free from headache. I got regular headache. Yes, sir. There is a energy center which we call as optic chasma. If you do the regular meditation, this optic chasma energy center get manifest. It manifests its quality. It get a lot of boost with the immune power, and this headache problem go permanently. So you try it for 8 or 10 days and observe the real result, and then you can understand how it goes away. But you need to do a regular meditation. Beginner, who could I will start to learn? Okay, the question, if I understand properly, I am beginner, where could I start? Sir, I posted one link on online meditation in the chat. You can go there and learn the online meditation. There are offline classes. You can just play and you can learn the meditation. Okay, sir, kindly explain how meditation can reduce the breathing and asthma. That is we cover. Sadhana ma'am, sir, at time we can go for at any time we can go meditation. Yes Sadhana ma'am, we can go any time in a meditation. There is no time limit for the meditation. Only one request is, after taking a lunch, dinner or breakfast, don't go for meditation for 30 minutes. Rest of the time you can go anytime. There is no limitation. So Reddy sir, how to control anger using yoga? I already answer. Tell some idea of mind relaxation for student, those who preparing for competitive exam. They are reading 6 hours daily. एक्चुअली दोस पीपल डू द रेगुलर मेडिटेशन, दे डोंट नीड टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ हार्ड वर्क. व्हाट हैपन, सपोज इफ वी आर रीडिंग, बट व्हेन वी आर रीडिंग और स्टडिंग एनी बुक्स और एनी टॉपिक, इफ आवर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी नॉट देयर एंड आवर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी देयर इन पास्ट और फ्यूचर, सो वॉट एवर वी आर रीडिंग इट विल नॉट गो 100% टू अवर ब्रेन. बट वेन यू डू अ मेडिटेशन एंड देन यू स्टार्ट रीडिंग, सो इवन 5 or 10 minute रीडिंग, योर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी कम्प्लीटली फोकस ऑन द वॉट एवर यू आर स्टडिंग ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. एंड ऑल्सो बाय डूइंग मेडिटेशन योर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन पावर एंड मेमरी पावर बोथ गेट इम्प्रूव, सो यू गेट अ 3 बेनिफिट. Just doing a 5 minute meditation before you start the study, your memory power increase, your concentration power increase, and when you do the study, you are totally focused on that particular topic. That's why this is very good for student. We did a lot of experiment in lot of different colleges student, and what we get the benefit from the what we got the feedback from the teachers and their parents, that by just doing the meditation, our kids get a very good result. He got the interest in study. Again, he's not just reading, but only one time reading, and his memory power got increased. So there are number of research paper also we have, which shows that this increase the memory power. So you can do this. You can ask the student to do this and experience in 8 or 10 days what the changes has occur by doing just meditation 5 minutes before the study. How to make unstable child stable state like a special kids, is there a solution? Yeah, this is, as I told, the meditation, this meditation we are doing does not have any age limitation. Even we are running for the kids, we are running for a student, we are running for home wife, senior citizen, all different categories. So each categories, if you do this meditation, everyone get the benefit. Like for kids, they get a, they will get relaxed, they get a lot of benefit, they get stable, their anger get reduced. So every section who are do this meditation, they get the benefit. I posted one link on feedback on the chat. I request you please share your feedback for today's session. Today is the last session, so I request you, all participants, if share their feedback, we may share some more information on you through mail or through WhatsApp. So please request you to share your feedback on the feedback form, which I posted on the chat. Okay, my relative is suffering from OCD for a long time. How Sahaj Yoga help her? Ma'am, this is a very good question. I can answer this in a detailed way. There are some technique which we could not explain in the today's session, as this is very introductory session. So if you I posted my number, if you can drop me one message on WhatsApp, I will share you one PDF or a PPT where it gives a step-by-step process how to control how to cure the OSD with the help of Sahaj Yoga. So maybe that will be nice if you can. I posted my question mobile number, you just WhatsApp me, I will share the relevant document to you. How to help the BP person? Yeah, BP person, very good question. I can show you one very interesting diagram how BP is happening and how we can control. Just let me, give me 1 minute, I can show you the logic behind the BP. One minute, I am showing one diagram, so that gives you a lot of understanding like how the BP can be helped. So let me know how to share my screen once again. 1 minute. Sir, how to share my screen? Okay, share something. 1 minute. Are you able to see my screen where I am showing one diagram? This diagram shows 5 steps to control and cure the blood pressure without any medicine. Are you able to see? Okay, here you can see when you are in a balanced state, what will happen? This acrotic plex distributing a proper energy to all the body organ. But when you are in an imbalanced state, this acrotic plex, which we call as Swadhisthana Chakra, which is giving a more energy to the brain. And that is why you see there is a blood pressure. So this is all the happening because of the blood pressure. So once you balance this acrotic plex, your blood pressure go away. Anyway, I am putting this link, a blog link here, so you can go in a detail and you can understand how to help the BP person without any medicine. So this is a link, you will get all detail. Shall we put the link on blog, sir? Yes, I put it. Shall I put the mention link in the website blog? Yeah, please give me your mobile number. I have already put it. Okay, so I have shared the link also. I am posting my mobile number also, and I request you, please fill the feedback form. That is again, I am posting here. Please fill the feedback form, and I am really happy to in. It is very interactive session today, and a lot of energy I see today. A lot of people are doing the meditation. That is very good sign. So I guess I completed my time. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity for interacting. If you want to set up any free Sahaj Yoga program in your colleges or in any other places, please feel free to contact us. We are setting the free of charge. There is no charge, just as a social cause we are doing. So thank you very much, Raju sir, if you are there. Please take the control. We completed from our side. Raju sir? Hello? Hello?
Chandrakant sir, yes.
Yes sir, thank you very much for giving this opportunity, sir. We enjoy a lot, and I completed my session from my end, sir. So should I log off, sir, from the meeting?
Yes, no problem, sir. If you are done, you can log off.
Yeah, okay. So thank you very much once again. I am logging off from the meeting.
Sure, fine, sir. Yeah, small instruction to all the participants. This is Prasad. Regarding today's what to call it as online exam. Am I audible for everyone?
Sir.
Am I audible? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Regarding our what to call it as session 3 and 4. Okay, now session 2, Raju sir will continue for 1 hour class. Once the class is done, we'll have some break from 11 to 11:15. And in the session 3, that is from 11:15 to 12:15, from Atal, we will be getting a link. A Google form will be uploaded into your WhatsApp group. Okay, so the time limit is also there for that particular Google form. Okay, it's not like we can fill that particular Google form till the end of the day. There is some time limit for the Google form, and once the Google form is done, we will be having some. Okay, we will be having some feedback. We will be taking some feedback from the participants. Sorry, sir, small disturbance. So once the Google form you will be filling, you will be having, we will be taking a feedback from some of the participants, and we'll start our test somewhere at 12:15. Important instructions over here are, unless and until you don't fill this Google form, your ID will not be activated for the test. Okay, so please fill the Google form and make sure that in the Google form, whatever the mail ID that you have registered, okay, so from that you have to do it. And the second, that is nothing but mail ID in the sense, please log into your Gmail account through which you have registered. From that you have to fill the Google form. Okay, so then only we will be activating your test. And even for writing the test, we have filled your details. Okay, I don't have any other details regarding you. I have only two things. One is your mail ID, and one is your your faculty FID. Okay, we have given you some FID. Okay, and based on these two things only, your test will be activated. So please make sure that everyone give your proper FIDs. Suppose example, your FID is NIT IOT. Okay, please give like this only, IOT. If it is 3003, okay, it is not this 3. Okay, this is wrong. We are not going to consider this. We will be considering only this because your ID is a 3-digit ID. If it is 23, you have to give as 023. Okay, so please make sure that your ID is also of 3 digits. Okay, and still I have seen a number of people are logging without your FIDs, and I am helpless at the end of the day. If you throw any queries, I'll not be able to take those queries. I already started giving instructions from the day two. Just please log in with your IDs. See, I'll just show you something. I don't know what to tell. Yesterday, while I was seeing my your attendance, which Atal has sent back to me. Just imagine if your this ID is not there. I don't know who is this. It's really nice that NIT IOT has attended almost the entire sessions, like 194, 62, and 14. If this ID was not there, there may be no name or some other details. Okay, so please make sure that you have proper IDs. It has taken me. Now you see, I don't have any information from this. I don't know who is this person, Harish, and my data is not matching. He's almost 31 minutes. He was available in my meeting, but unfortunately I'm helpless that I can't help, because you see, even no mail ID and even ID is there, and even you can see some. So please try to understand our side also. Okay, so please, these are even you can see this one. I don't have any details regarding this, so how can I consider key whether he's a participant or not? So all those things, many of your cases has been automatically deleted. Okay, so please, at the end of the day, you should not blame me. Okay, so please, please try to understand our problems also. Okay, so please, it's a humble request, everyone log in only with your FID. FID is very important, unless and until, and even you are not allowed to give like this. Some of you have given like this key FDP ID. This is my ID. Okay, so this is also not going to consider. Please, it's a humble request. This is also not going to consider. It's only FID. Okay, NIT003. Is need AICT faculty? Okay, I'll take your doubts later. But please, please try to understand our thing. See, this particular Google form is, okay, feedback Google form is only for certain period of time. Once the feedback Google form is activated, we'll be having some 20 to 25 minutes. By that time, your test will be activated. Once I'll post exactly somewhere at 12:10, okay, 12:10, I'll post the link regarding the test. The link will start, exam will start from 12:15 to 1:15. Okay, and exactly at 1:35, your test link will be closed. And if you are not able to write the test within that time, I'm really sorry, I'll be helpless. Okay, so please try to understand from our end. Okay, so if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Voice not audible, Raju Kishore, no voice. I think now my voice is clear. I have registered with my college mail, not Gmail. Sir, from, I don't know, Ashok sir, I am handling the every day. Now you are requesting ki, sir, I have registered with my college mail, not with Gmail. Okay, please WhatsApp me so that I can try to change it. But I don't have in my right now, I don't have anything in my hand, because already the data has been shared with them. If it is possible, I can try to share. Are you sharing screen? For what, sir? I didn't get you, sir. 251. Sharma, sir, I'm really sorry. Are you sharing screens? Screen means I didn't get you. Definitely, I'll share my Google link. Okay, for the exam. Thanks. Is needed AICT faculty is needed in Google Forms? Sir, I was not able to take this question. Is needed AICT faculty is needed in Google Forms? Okay, I really don't know. Please show once my ID, sir. 320. Definitely, sir. Just a second. 320. 320. Yes. B. Rashekar Reddy, sir. Right. And next. I also register with my college ID. Is it no problem, sir? College ID is different. College ID is different and FID is different. Okay. Am I also use my college mail ID? It is not considered. College mail ID, no problem, sir. You can use any mail ID. Only make sure that I need to identify you. Like FID is, if you go with this FID, definitely I can extract all the information from you. Exam link will send to mail ID. No, it will be shared in the WhatsApp group. Okay, and even in the chat, we will be sharing the exam link, yeah, feedback link only in the WhatsApp group. So show us our attendance once again, sir. Sir, that I have done already. 234. Let me show you your attendance. 234. I'm just showing yesterday's attendance. Vijay sir, this is your yesterday's attendance. 122 minutes. Total minutes yesterday we have recorded is 265 minutes, and you were there for yesterday were there for 122 minutes. I have registered with my college ID. No problem, sir. College ID, mail ID, no problem. Please share the finalist, sir. Already, Sadhana ma'am, yesterday itself I already shared. It's in the a WhatsApp group. Okay, no new post way there. You can just check from there. Is it valid? Yes, sir. Valid only. 171. Is there any cutoff marks to get certificate, sir? I already conveyed. It is 80 marks. 80% should be there. Please provide total attendance. Sure, definitely after this I'll share. Can we attempt yeah, you can attempt exam in the mobile. There is no need to worry about it. Yes, you can attend. And very important thing, I was able to take something, but unfortunately I was not able to recall. Sir, yesterday I absent for 40 minutes. Is there any problem? No, already we have conveyed per certificate. Already I have conveyed attendance. Okay, so now I think I have taken lots of time. I have to hand over the session to Raju sir. Okay, because maybe sir is waiting, and if any queries are there, definitely I'll take these queries after what to call it as after this after Raju sir's class. Chandra sir, are you audible? Chandra sir,
hello Prasad sir.
Ah sir, tell me.
Yeah, some problem here with the Raju sir system, but we are going to fix it in a while.
Okay, then by the time I'll be taking some calls. Okay. Once yeah, it is done, sure. You just intimate me so that I can give
sure,
no certificate
sure.
If you get. Okay.
Sure.
If any questions, yes. Sir, it shows my attendance at 12:15. Sir, don't worry, I'll share all the details because see the attendance I am not taking from my end. See the attendance is taken automatically. I'll show you yesterday's. Okay. So yesterday's recording, nothing is in my hand. Everything is through Google. Sorry, go to meeting. Everything you can see. Suppose if you take yesterday's day four, okay, and you can see here. This is your attendance, which is auto-generated attendance. It is not from my end, okay. See, this is auto-generated attendance. You can directly meet because every day we are sharing this link to what to call it as every day. Once the meeting is done, immediately this link is shared to Atal. Okay, so nothing is in our hand and we are not even modifying or whatever
Hello.
Is there. Everything is through Hello. What to call it as ultimate. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, Professor okay. Raju sir is ready actually.
Sir, just
okay?
Just a second. My
voice is clear.
Okay. Yes, your voice is clear, sir. Can I make Raju sir as presenter, sir? Chandra, sir?
Yeah, Prasad. Prasad.
Yes, sir, yes. Make him, sir.
Yeah, I have shared the screen, sir.
Hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Professor.
Sir. Chandra sir, tell me.
Just to give share to Raju sir.
Okay, directly to Raju sir. Okay.
Yeah.
There are two IDs with Raju sir. So
two IDs are there.
Yeah. Just check it, sir. I have shared it. I think sir has logged on phone as well as laptop.
Yeah. He's in logged on two IDs. We'll let you know, sir. Which one? Sir, present prokoti chanting ichar ga. Adi ga konda vere dan kevande.
Okay. Fine, sir. Yes, sir. I have given.
Yes, sir. Thank you. You got it.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now. this here now.
Yes, sir. ID 87, please mute your audio. Professor, sir, are you there?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, just from this laptop, is it okay, sir?
Yeah, it's okay, sir. From your end, there is no disturbance, only from ID 187. Sir, now it's clear. You can.
Prasad, is it audible?
Yes, sir. Sir, audible, sir. Raju, sir, it's audible.
Okay, then, right. Yeah, today's agenda, basically we'll discuss about the basics of Internet of Things and various applications of IoT, basic of agri-informatics and farming basis, and agri sensors and their uses, different sensors we'll be discussing, and the challenges in agriculture, greenhouse farming, and different practices, cost-effective practices using greenhouse. So we'll be discussing these things in today's agenda. Yeah, concept of IoT is, basic concept of IoT is to make entire world connected. We need to connect the entire world. That means each and every electronic object, it has to be accessible, it has to be addressable, and it has to be actionable. So whatever the electronic device you are going to connect with this particular IoT, that particular device should have, it has to be addressable, and it has to be accessible, and it has to be actionable. You need to action. You can make action from anywhere, anytime, anything, any related electronic device. when it is then addressable, then only you can make any sort of action. When it is having a particular address, then only you can access it. Then you can make any sort of action. So a particular device, whatever the device you have, it has to be addressable, accessible, and actionable. Suppose internet appears everywhere in the world. Wherever internet appears, your thing, whatever the electronic thing you are having, it can be connected. And once it has been connected, you can do action and you can access from anywhere. So that is the thing. Suppose internet appears everywhere in the world, connection between people and people. Till now, we have connected between people and people only. We have not connected between things and things. Till now, with the help of internet, we have connected between people and people. But we are going to connect with the help of internet. We are going to connect the things, different things. That is nothing but the internet of things. So internet connects all the people. We say it as internet of people. So till now, we have connected only people with the help of internet. With the help of internet, we have connected only people, one with the another. But now with the help of these particular things, we are going to connect one thing with the another thing. Suppose I'm having an egg tray. I'm having an egg tray. What my egg tray will do is, when I'm having a 15 eggs in my egg tray, when it is nearly going to complete, that means when 4 or 5 eggs are remaining or 3 eggs are remaining, your egg tray will inform you only 3 eggs are remaining. Suppose your refrigerator or your milk packet, every day you'll be consuming some 2 liters of milk, and today very less amount. That means only 1 liter is available, or like only less amount of milk is available, then it will message you. Or suppose if you can take a refrigerator, your smart refrigerator, it will check the total nutrient content of your family. Suppose you'll be having the vegetables, you'll be having the fruits, you'll be having the sweets, you'll be having each and everything. So suppose weekly basis, or suppose daily basis, what sort of nutrient you are using, what sort of nutrients you are taking, is this nutrient enough to your body, is this nutrient enough to your family, it will check, and accordingly it will tell you that these particular vitamins are deficient to you, these nutrients are needed for your family, because you have not consumed these particular things. Your smart refrigerator is going to give you the information. So that's the thing. So IoT connects all the things. We call it as Internet of Things. Any place, any time, and anything connection, we call it as the IoT. On the move, anytime connection, it is on the move. It may be indoors or it may be the outdoors, anywhere. Nighttime or it may be daytime, anytime. Any place connection, on the move, outdoors, indoors, a PC, anything. It may be a PC, or it may be a cell phone, or it may be a TV with your refrigerator. Or suppose I can tell you a particular live example. Suppose I went to lunch to my house, and I was watching TV, and suddenly there is a power off, and I had my lunch, and I forgot to off my TV and off my phone, off my fan and my air conditioner, and I locked my house and I came back. After 1 to 2 hours, I knew that I have not off my TV and my air conditioner or my fan or other appliances which are available in my house, because I forgot. So how to activate, or that means how to operate it from, I came back to my college. After having my lunch, I came back to my college. Now, dynamically, I cannot operate from my college, but with the help of IoT, you can operate dynamically. You can operate it from anywhere, anytime, anything. Your fan is connected with you. Your TV is connected with you. Your refrigerator is connected with you. Your air condition is connected with you. Your each and every thing is connected with you. Each and everything is connected with you. Suppose I can give another example. Suppose you are going to your house. You have completed your college at 4 o'clock and you are going to your house at 5. If you can on your AC at 4:30, now by the way you go to your house, your room will be cool. You can directly enjoy. You can directly, because if you start your AC at a time you reach, then it will take another 10 to 15 minutes or 20 minutes to get your room cool. Now, the time you go to your room will be already cooled. Then you can enjoy it. Suppose you had rice in your cooker. You had rice in your cooker and you are starting at your college at 4 o'clock, and it will take 1 hour to reach your destination, that is your house, at 5 o'clock. It will take another 1 hour. Now you can on your rice cooker. You can on your rice cooker. The way, the time you reach your house, your rice will be ready. Your rice will be ready. That means you can operate. You can dynamically operate from anywhere, anytime. Cost efficiency. You are reducing the cost. Suppose normal way, what we will do? Suppose I didn't off my TV. I didn't off my air conditioner. I didn't off my fan. Or I didn't off my stereo or some other thing. Again, you have to go to your house and you have to off each and everything. But now it is not like that. You can operate. You can switch off from anywhere, anytime, because each and everything is connected. Each and everything dynamically you are controlling. You are automating each and everything. Automation in each and every field. Whatever the electronic devices which are addressable, which are actionable, which are accessible, all these devices you are controlling from anywhere, anytime, anything. You are controlling. Once you are controlling, your life is getting easier. Your life is getting more and more easier, much easier. You don't need to go, if you are far away, you don't need to go again and again to switch off something, some sort of electronic devices. Why Internet of Things? Dynamic control of industry and daily life. Dynamic control. You don't need to see, trends are moving towards IoT. Today's trend, today's industry is moving towards IoT. It affects you in your daily life, in each and everything. Whatever the electronic devices you are having, you are using your TV, you are using the electronic device, refrigerator, your AC, your stereo, okay, your cell phone, okay, there are number of, at least in each and every household, we are having minimum of 10 to 15 electronic devices we are having. You can, suppose I'm having a particular cell phone, my cell phone has fallen down and I need to replace it. Now my cell phone, it will call itself to the customer care and it can order the particular part, whatever the part it has been broken, it will directly replace it, or it will directly message you, and it will directly, suppose it is a particular Samsung phone, then it will directly send a message. Or suppose a milk vendor, suppose only 1 liter of milk is available, but daily you need 5 liters of milk. Only 1 liter is available. Whenever 1 liter of milk is available, it will give the message to the a particular milk shop or milk some other this one, so that you can directly get the milk. You don't need to involve in these particular things. Each and every, that means each and every electronic devices will be synchronizing with another device, and it will do its work by itself. So that is the thing. Dynamic control of industry and daily life. So our lives are going to be much easier in coming days. Our lives are going to be much easier within the coming days, because each and every device we are able to control. So you don't need to go. That means dynamically you can control wherever you are. Wherever you are, you can control from anywhere. You have seen, you may have seen, suppose V-Guard advertisement. V-Guard advertisement, you have seen maybe. The cine hero Mahesh Babu, he's tried to off the fan, or he's tried to off the AC which is available in his relative's house. That means he's dynamically controlling from one place to the another place. Lloyd or V-Guard related things he is controlling. We got an advertisement, isn't it? See, this is the thing. So improves resource utilization ratio. That means day by day resource utilization, that is electronic devices, synchronization, communication is improving. Better relationship with this particular human and nature. Every time, every day, whatever the new electronic devices, we are having the more relationship. That means we are communicating, we are synchronizing with the different devices. Universal transport and networking, accessibility and the usability. Why should I learn? Business trends. Business trends are towards this particular IoT. Today, each and every trend. Suppose, I can give you an example with the help of IoT. Suppose you are a weekly traveler, or you are most traveler in a particular sector. Suppose Hyderabad to Delhi. You are a traveler. Suppose when you are traveling, and within a particular week or within a particular month, if a particular airline is not having the enough customers, then it will target you because you are the frequent traveler. With the help of IoT, that means target advertisement. Target who are the customers who are most frequent travelers within a particular sector. What sort of discount, what sort of advantage if I can give to these particular customers so that my seats can be filled. So these are the 30% customers who are traveling more frequently. If I can give 30% discount on the ticket, if they can travel in this particular week or within this particular day, then I can give 30% discount, or I can give 40% discount. And you can predict that he can travel within that particular day or within that particular week. So like target advertising. So that's the thing. So next revolution, information revolution, is towards the IoT. Innovative business process. So we are having innovative business process within this particular IoT. New customer services. So every time new customers, new services are towards adding advantages towards this particular IoT industry. So what you need? What are the basic needs of the IoT? What you need to get it done? What you need? So basic understanding of program. You need the basic programming, you need the basic operating systems, and you need the basic networking and basic overview of electronics. If you know these particular basics of programming and operating systems and networking as well as the electronics, you can easily get into these particular IoT. Okay. And internet has connected 1 billion people. So we are now have connected 1 billion people with the help of internet, but we have not at all connected with the things. As we have connected with the people, we have not connected with the things. So that's the thing. Mobile connected 2 billion people. IoT is expected to connect around 50 billion by 2020. By 2020, it is going to connect the 50 billion from ranging from small pill, ranging from the pill bracelets to the flights, okay, to the aeroplanes and cars. So it is not in a particular industry. Like we cannot say it is in a IoT is available in a only an education sector or in a some industry sector or in some other sector. It is available in manufacture, in industry, okay, in production, in each and every sector, wherever you are having the electronic things, wherever you are having the electronic gadgets, these particular IoT is available. Okay, so IoT connects device on the network. IoT gathers and manage of this device via different software. So IoT gathers the information. So what I will do is I will connect the device, I will collect the data, I will process the data, I will process the data using different softwares. Once I will be processing, I'll be using with the help of different analytics, with the help of different IoT tools and techniques, I will process it and I will distribute the orders. That means I will collect the data. Whatever the data I have collected, I will process the data. Whatever the data I have processed with the help of the different algorithm, I'll be getting some sort of conclusions. Solutions. That solution I can pass. Suppose if you can see greenhouse environment, we are having different sensors are connected. Suppose temperature sensor is connected with the system. Okay, temperature, humidity, okay, air sensors, okay, and soil sensors, okay, water sensors, okay, related number of sensors are available. Suppose a particular plant, if you can see paddy, a particular paddy, its stages, based upon its stages, 1 to 10 days, its water content should be so and so. From 11 to 20 days, its water content is so and so. And 11 to 20, its fertilizer and pesticide has to be given is so and so. That means you are having total rules and regulations already. The rules and regulations are available with you. Based upon the rules and regulations, you will process it with your algorithm. Based upon the day, based upon the nature of the plant, based upon the availability, disease, or based upon the day, based upon that particular plant, you will take the decision what has to be done. You'll be taking the decision what has to be done based upon the input. See, you'll be getting the inputs every time. Suppose temperature sensor will be sending the input to your centralized system. Air or pressure or pH value or water related sensor, okay, soil related sensor or nutrient related sensor or color related sensor, your camera will click every day one photo to different plants, and it will send that particular image to the your centralized system. Now your centralized system is getting different inputs from different sensors. Your centralized system is getting every time a particular image from the camera. Your system is getting the input from the pressure or the temperature or the water levels, okay, or the humidity, okay, or the soil levels, and so on. Based upon these things, you are having an algorithm, you will run the algorithm. So if temperature is so and so, if humidity is so and so, if your water content is so and so, then do so and so. You are having algorithms, you are having rules and regulations. You will just process your algorithms, and accordingly you will take the decision, you will be making the decision. So that is the thing. IoT gathers and management of these devices via software. IoT is network of physical objects embedded with electronic operator with other device. Remote control. It will be allowing you the remote control. You can be at anywhere. Anytime, anything. It should be an electronic device. It should have an address. It should be an addressable, accessible, and actionable. Whatever the electronic device, you want to make the action. whatever the electronic device you want to control, you want to dynamically control from anywhere, anytime, anything, whatever the thing you want to control from anywhere, that particular device, it has to be electronic device, and it should have the properties. It should be actionable, it should be accessible, okay, and it should be addressable. Then only you can make any sort of action, and it gets that particular action. Allows remote control. So direct integration of computer plus physical world. The result is automation in each and every field. I'm not only telling about a particular field, like education field or an industry or an automobile or a traffic control or a particular other thing. Wherever the electronic device is available, you can control, you can make control in each and every sector. It is not to a particular sector, it is to each and every sector. It is connected, you can control to each and every sector. So that is the thing, automation in all the fields. So once it is automated, your life is going to be easier. Your life is going to be easier. You can relax. See, by the way I go to my house, I can rest it directly because I have on my AC half an hour before. Already, I have on my AC half an hour before, I can directly go and enjoy. Already I have put my rice and my electrical cooker is on. By the way I go to my house, my rice will be ready. I can directly have it. So that is the thing. Automation in each and every field. So how IoT works? It works with the internet, with the sensors and IoT devices. You need to connect different electronic devices. You need to connect it. Suppose, as we have discussed, greenhouse automation. Suppose we have different devices like temperature related device, humidity related device, pressure related device, okay, and water content related sensor devices, and a nutrient content device, soil content device, okay, like we are having n number of devices. All these n number of devices are connected to the centralized system. Now these devices will be giving the sensor related data to this particular centralized system. Now the centralized system will process this particular, it will collect the data, it will process this particular data with the help of some sort of algorithm, and it will distribute the orders. So what sort of, suppose my day is 10th day, I have planted before 10 days, now it is 10th day. So what sort of decision making I have to do today? What sort of decision making? That is the thing. I have collected the data, and I have collected, I have done the analysis with the help of some algorithms, and I can distribute the orders. It connects with the internet and other device surroundings. Whatever the devices you have connected, various number of devices you have connected, you will be connecting with these particular devices, and you will do the analysis, and you will be distributing the orders. Collects the information, it does analysis as per the program, whatever the program, you will be writing the program. Suppose we are having the paddy, or we are having the chillies, or we are having the particular cotton, each and every crop will be having a different parameters, each and every crop will be having different functionalities, each and everything will be having different features. So a day, suppose if you can see paddy, then you need to have total 24 hours very good amount of water usage. But when compared with paddy, other crops, suppose like cotton, or suppose some other chilies, or some other crop, if you can see, you don't need 24 hours water. High content of water is not needed to the other plants or other crops, whereas it needs high content, high usage of water. Based upon that, I can have a, suppose your sensor will be measuring the water content every day, every time, every second, every minute. If the water content is less than your threshold, you'll be having the threshold. If it is less than your threshold, then it will send a message to the centralizer system that now the available water content is less than that of the actual need to a particular plant. Accordingly, that means you will be ordering the pump to on the motor. So that is the thing. Here the problem is, suppose water content is very less, it has sent the message to the centralized system. Now centralized system has been analyzed with its algorithm, and it has known that the water content within the paddy is less than that of its normal usage, normal need. Now the your algorithm has been detected, and now it will on the motor. So that is the thing. That means it does analysis as per your program. You are writing the program according to a particular crop. Suppose for paddy, you will be writing the program in a different view, in which way you need, what are the parameters you need for the paddy, for first 1 day to the 10 days, or from 11th to 20th days, or from 21st to 30th days, or 31st to 48th days. So what are the parameters? What are the functionalities you need? Okay. So based upon that, you'll be writing the program according to your program needs. Your system will behave. It will process it, and accordingly, it will make the decision, and it will distribute the orders. It will distribute the orders according to your need. Suppose, what is the scope of connectivity? Consider your house. Your house is addressable as it is having a particular address. Suppose my house is situated in Prashant Nagar, which is opposite of NIT Warangal. My house is having a particular house number and a street number, and nearby landmark I am having. NIT is nearby landmark, okay? And I am in Hanamkonda Mandal, okay? And in Warangal. That means if you can send a particular letter, or if you can send a particular post or courier or anything, I'll directly get to my house. In the same way, that means your house is addressable. That means your house is having a particular house number, your house is having a particular street name, and nearby landmark and mandal and district and state and country and pin code. That means your house is addressable with these particular features and parameters. To locate your house should have a particular pin code. To locate your house should have some street name, and it should have your house number, and it should have some mandal name, and district name, and a state name, and so on. Then only I can connect to my house. In the same way. Whatever the electronic device you want to access, you want to action, you want to address, you need that particular electronic device should have all these parameters. It should have some minimum parameters. Then only you can address. Then only you can make action. Then only you can access it. So that is the thing. Accessible. You can send a courier or post. Whenever your house is having particular house address, then only you can send the courier or a post to your house. Not accessible. You cannot close your door from here. You cannot close your door from here. It is not possible to close the door from. So now I am at my NIT. I'm not able to close my door from my NIT. It is not possible. Not possible to operate from long distance, but with the help of IoT, you can close the door. House automation, home automation, you can close your door. Suppose if you can see your house, if each and everything has been automated, you can close your door. Or whenever you enter in your house, you can, while you enter in your house, your lights will be on. Once you went out, your lights will be automatically will be off. Or whenever you are on, you have entered in your hall, your fan will be on. You don't need to on your switch directly, it will be on. Or suppose sometimes if you can clap, we are able to see in a TV, or we are able to see in some other medias, like if you can clap also, your fan will be on, your TV will be on, or your lights will be on and off. If once you can clap, it will be on, and again if you can clap, it will be off. So this is the thing, like, okay, so not possible to operate from the long distance. It is not possible to operate it from the long distance. What IoT results? Automation in each and every field. Once automation in each and every field, our life will be made easier, much easier, much easier. You don't need to go to house and you need to have the rice there after reaching your house. You don't need to have, because already you have started. You have on your rice cooker. Once you have started, once you reach your house, your rice will be cooked. You have on your AC. Once you reach it, already it will be, your room will be on. So that is the thing. Your life will be much easier day by day. That is the thing. Increases efficiency. Dynamically, we can control each and everything. I can control my TV, I can control my fan, I can control my AC, I can control my refrigerator. My refrigerator can send something is not available to the some other person, like, or some other vendor, or some other shopkeeper or shop owner, something. Okay, so it can send it the message, each and everything. That means automatically you have written the program in such a way, if it reaches the threshold, then do so and so. If my milk packet is only one, then order the milk. Or if my egg tray is having only two, then order the eggs. Just order the eggs. It will be automatically, by default, it will be ordered, because you have written the program in such a way, once it reaches two, then you need to order it. Or if you can see the refrigerator, it will check, it will calculate the nutrient control, it will calculate the nutrients needed for your family. It will calculate it and it will give the message that these particular vitamins are not, you have not taken within this particular week. So you try to take to balance your nutrient content. These particular nutrients are not consumed by your body. These particular vitamins are very, very important. These particular fruits are not very, very important. Like, it can suggest to you, because it will calculate each and everything. Whatever the vegetables or whatever the food or whatever the fruits which are available, or food content, or what, based upon that it will calculate daily basis, and it can give you the information that so and so only available and these are not available. Okay, so that's the thing. It increases the efficiency, enables new services, achieves health and safety, connected with added security, analytics and management capabilities. If you can see this, in 2003, things are very, very small. In 2003, suppose if you can see blue color are things. In 2003, it is very, very small. Slowly it has been increased in 2010. In 2015, it has much increased, and by 2020, 50 billion things are going to be connected. 50 billion things are going. See, slowly things are being connected. So year by year. In 2003, very, very less. In 2003, very small amount of things have been connected. In 2010, it has been increased. In 2015, further increase. And in 2020, 50 billion things are going to be connected. Suppose, here is an example. Telephone communicates with the coffee machine to make a certain type of coffee at certain hour for a certain number of people. How the objects are communicating with each other? Suppose a group of, suppose computer science, engineering, group of professors, they are going to a particular coffee shop for a particular type of coffee at a particular time, daily basis. They are going to the coffee shop at 4 o'clock to a particular coffee shop for a particular type of coffee, a particular group of professors, a particular group, daily basis. That means daily basis they are going for this particular coffee, then your coffee vending machine will understand at a particular time a group of professors are going to have this particular coffee at a particular coffee shop. That means the coffee shop owner has to check whether all the related ingredients are available or milk is available or related. That means these professors are taking a particular type of special coffee. Only these particular people are within that particular college are taking the coffee from this particular coffee shop. Only 10 people. Other than these people, these 10 people, no other people within the total college are not taking a particular type of coffee. That means the owner can understand, the coffee vending machine can understand that whether milk is available or the ingredients are available related to that particular coffee or not. It will understand. If it is not available, if the ingredients or if the coffee or coffee powder or if related milk is not available or related some other ingredient is not available, then the coffee machine will message the owner and another shop to get that particular ingredient. Object that remember the owner's favorite food and order it from a certain restaurant. Suppose a particular customer every day, weekend, he is ordering a particular food to a particular restaurant. Every weekend, maybe Sunday, every Sunday he is ordering a particular type of food to a particular restaurant. Then the system can understand and it will give you a message that today is a Sunday, you need to order a particular type of food to this particular restaurant because it is of your favorite food. A broken phone orders itself a new component from the support center. Suppose your phone has fallen down, your screen has damaged, or your receiver has been damaged, your earphone or something your microphone or something has been damaged, then it itself will order to that particular company support center. It will order itself. Some of the applications, target advertisement to the customized content. So media IoT plus big data. See, as we have discussed, one particular customer is a frequent traveler. Within a particular sector, then with the help of this particular IoT and big data analytics, we can target only those particular person who are frequently traveling between that particular sector, So target advertising will target only that particular sector. Other sectors are okay, but within this particular sector, there are some seats are vacant. So we will target to those particular customers who are frequently traveling in that particular sector. Infrastructure management, monitoring structural condition, scheduling maintenance. It can check the scheduling maintenance also. Waste management, if you can see the waste management. Suppose municipality will accommodate different bins at different places within a particular municipality. Every day the municipality van has to check whether the bin is empty or full. Based upon the, if it is full, then it will take that particular bin, or if it is 50% full, then again the van driver will check next day. That means unnecessary, it is time waste and it is costly affair. Then what we can do is we can have a sensor which is placed on a top of the bin. Once it is 80% filled, bin id will be sent to the municipality that so and so particular bin has been totally full. That means now the van driver will collect the details of the different bins, and accordingly which of the bins are 100% full, only those bins he will collect it, and he doesn't need to go to the other related areas. So we can save the time and we can save the money also, because suppose he needs to roam entire city, suppose daily a particular vehicle needs to travel for 10 kilometers because each and every bin he has to check whether that particular bin is full or empty, whether it is a full or empty. Now he doesn't need to go to each and every bin, because whatever the bin which has been full, that particular bin will be sending the message to the municipal corporation, and whenever he starts for bin collection, then only those particular bin which are full, only those particular bins which are full, those he can collect it. He doesn't need to go to the other bins. That means he can save the time as well as the he can save the time as well as he can so sensing as a service we can say it as a sensing as a service. Various applications we have. Applications of IoT: building and home automation, manufacturing, medical and healthcare systems, media systems. We have the media systems, environment monitoring systems, infrastructure management, energy management, transportation, agriculture, and so on. Advertisement, energy management, transportation, agriculture. Yeah, coming to the agri information system, about 75% of people are living in rural areas and depending upon the agriculture. So our main occupation is the agriculture, and most of the people are living in the rural areas and depending upon the agriculture, and agriculture continues to play the major role in Indian economy. It is playing the vital role. Like we are having different milestones. We are having different milestones. Green Revolution 1968, Evergreen Revolution 1996, Blue Revolution, White Revolution, Yellow Revolution, Biotechnology Revolution, and now currently ICT Revolution. So we need to have the agriculture with the help of the ICT technologies. Why we need to have the smart farming? Global food challenge of feeding more than 9 billion people in 2050. See, year by year, day by day, resources are limited. See, our land is limited. Land usage is very, very limited. And people are migrating from rural areas to the urban areas. Nobody is interested to have the agriculture as their occupation, as their profession. So that is the thing. We need 9 billion people in 2050 to feed the food. So that is the thing. We need to have more and more research in this particular agri farming systems. Involvement of agriculture knowledge system includes farmers, researchers, scientists, industry consultants, and advisors. There are number of problems we have. Number of problems related to this particular agriculture. Convolution, conventional, normal farming problem. Suppose you can say flood and drought related problems, unexpected rainfall. You cannot predict when rainfall occurs. Flood and drought, you cannot control. Shortage of water because of the year by year climate change. Every year temperature is increasing. So that is the thing. Groundwater is decreasing. So that is the thing. Every year, shortage of water. Every year, new diseases. We are unable to predict the diseases. As the farmer is illiterate, he is not able to predict the disease in a timely manner. He is unable to predict the disease in timely manner, and he is unable to have the pesticide or insecticide. See, whatever the shopkeeper or shop owner, fertilizer shop owner, whatever he suggests, accordingly he will spray or he will use the fertilizer or the pesticide, but he is not having the knowledge to use ICT tools and techniques. A farmer is not at all using the ICT tools and techniques. So that is the thing. He is unable to predict the disease. Village people are moving to urban every year because they don't want to, they are not interested. They need the secure life. They don't want to take agriculture as their profession. They don't want to take the agriculture as their profession. It is not a dignified profession like software. Each and everyone want to do software. Each and everyone want to become a doctor, or each and everyone want to do something, but nobody want to became a agriculture profession. Nobody want to take as agriculture as a profession. Declining share of agriculture in GDP. 55% is depending upon the agriculture. See, most of the things, most of the people are depending upon the agriculture. See, people are increasing day by day, year by year, people are increasing, but land, availability land is same. Suppose within a particular family, we have some 10 acres and 5 people within that particular family, each and every, now the 10 acres has been divided among 5 people. Among the 5 people. Now the 10 acres has divided into 5 people. That means each and everyone will get 2 acres. Each and everyone will get 2 acres. Again, now a particular family is having only 2 acres. He is having 2 children. Again, these 2 acres, each and everyone, 2 children will get 1 acre. Now again, so the family grows. That means here, family is growing. Whereas, is land growing? No, the land is not growing. Land is decreasing. That means people are increasing and land usage. Each and every household, each and every family, they need to give to their children and so on. Like in that particular way, the every time each and every family will be getting a very small amount of land. With that particular, they have to survive the family. So that is the thing. Limited access to irrigation. Limited access. Suppose they doesn't know when to water a particular plant. They don't know. They are not having enough skills. They are not educated. They are not having enough skills. When to have a particular pesticide, when to have a particular insecticide. They are not having that much skills. So whatever the shop dealer tells, you can use this particular, suppose dealer will get more commission on that particular pesticide, he will tell if you use this one. And after 10 days, now the disease is much more than earlier. No, it has not. Again, the farmer will go to that particular same shop and what he will do? No, whatever the pesticide or whatever the insecticide you have given has not worked. Okay, then you can use this alternative. Another one, he will give another one. But the farmers are also not having the accessibility. They are not having enough accessibility to the agriculture scientist. We are having very less agriculture institutions or agriculture universities or agriculture scientists, agriculture advisors, very, very less. We have very, very less. So that is the thing. Nobody is moving towards this particular profession. Limited access to the irrigation, limited accessibility to institutional credit. Nobody gives the credit. Nobody gives the loan. Nobody gives the loan. Nobody gives the input subsidies. Nobody gives the crop insurance. The farmers are not available about the insurances related. So these are the main problems. Yield is less with the conventional agriculture. Quality is low. Farmers are poor. Post-harvest losses. They are not aware how to, where to store and how to store it. They are not aware. Unable to market. Suppose marketing strategies. Suppose if you can see the marketing strategies. Warangal, the market price is different, and if you can see Hyderabad, the market prices will be different, and suppose if you can see Nagpur, the market prices will be different, okay, and suppose if you can see Mumbai market, the market prices will be totally different. That means the farmer is not aware. The farmer is not aware about the best price and transportation charges. Suppose if we want to market in Mumbai market, where the market prices are, the transportation prices are more. In the suppose from Warangal to Mumbai, the transportation itself, it will take 50,000, whereas the profit he may not get, because everything he may have to have it for transportation itself. So that's the thing. So lot of things, so all these things, all these issues we can overcome with the help of the IoT. Here are some of the challenges: increase in population, decrease in agriculture land, climate change, natural hazards, excess. See, when the farmer is not aware when to use a particular fertilizer, when to use a particular pesticide, he is not aware. You don't need to use that particular pesticide or insecticide, but he is not aware, he is not having that much information, he will use it. But with that particular insecticide or pesticide, the plant gets zero energy. The plant will not be getting any sort of energy with that particular insecticide or the pesticide. But the farmer is not known. Farmer has not been guided. Nobody has been guided, or nobody is guiding the farmer. No advisors, no scientists, no professors, or no agriculture universities. There are in each and every state one or two agriculture universities. The education is very, very less within this particular sector. So that is the thing. We are not able to have much more within this particular. Low literacy rates, weak digital literacy, remote areas, weak technical skills. They are not having enough technical skills. So that is the thing. So the only option the particular farmers is having is traders. They are having these traders. Whatever the trader tells, they will use that, and they will have it. They will use. If it is okay, then it's okay. Else, they will again go to the trader and they will have the another particular pesticide or the insecticide. So these are the information needs to the farmer. Pre-sowing, seeds related, fertilizers, pesticides, credit related, loan related, weather related, what is the weather for next 10 days, next 20 days, or suppose you have to give the information which related seeds or which related crops has to sown. At what particular time? At what particular time? See, yesterday, 2-3 days back, the Telangana government has been giving the information that whatever the crops the government gives, only those crops the farmers have to sow it, else they will not be giving the particular credit related information. The government is giving every acre some 5,000 credit, that particular credit they are not giving. So that is the thing. If you are not able to have these particular, that means whatever the government is giving that particular crop, if you are not able to have that particular crop, then they will not be giving, they will cut the credits whatever the government is giving. So that is the thing. So pre-harvest or harvest, post-harvesting, what sort of techniques, tools and techniques you have to use for the post-harvesting, and pest management, harvest management and packing techniques and all this. Marketing related information, marketing related information, mandi related information, market channels, commodity prices, expert guidelines, guidances, and with enough information, all these things you need to know. Okay, with this, I end this session, and I hand over to Prasad for the feedback as well as the feedback and the examination. Thank you.
సార్ చెప్తుండే ఇప్పుడు ఈ సార్ చెప్తుండే ఇప్పుడు ఇది చెప్పట్లేదు కదా ఏమి అది మూవ్ అవుతూనే ఉంది ఇంకెవరికి ఆన్సర్స్ కావాలట మనం రాతమా డిస్టమ్ అన్న పేరు పెడతామా లాస్ట్